All right. What we're going to do? So then our first mnemonic. First way of remembering physics equations. And this first mnemonic I'm going to teach you is going to help you remember four different physics equations. So I'm going to say it first, and then I want you to repeat it with me. This is a glorious prop. It will help, if you like, as a visual aid. So, this is a mnemonic. This is a memory aid. Sing a tune down the street. Find a man with my guitar. That's it. There's nothing else to it. So repeat it with me. Sing a tune down the street. Find a man with my guitar. There we go. You've just learned your first mnemonic, your first memory aid. And that is going to help you remember four different equations. Marvellous. Let's talk about that slightly more. Okay, so, sing a tune. What's that going to teach us? Well, what we're interested in is the first letter of each word. Sing a tune. So S from sing gives us speed. The letter A from A is for acceleration. T from tune gives us time. So speed equals acceleration times time. Change in speed equals acceleration times change in time. So we've got our next one. Sing a tune down the street. Distance, D. T gives us time. And S, the street, gives us speed. Distance equals time times speed. So we sing a tune down the street. Find a man. Force equals acceleration times mass. Finally, with my guitar, WMG, weight equals mass times gravity. So let's examine this. Let's examine our very first one there. Sing a tune. Speed equals acceleration times time. Now, if we write that in the triangle format, then we can use that to rearrange the equation however we want. So we have speed at the top, acceleration times time down the bottom of the triangle. And if we want to calculate speed, I just cover over speed in the triangle. And what I'm left with is acceleration times time. So speed equals acceleration times time. But what if I want the acceleration? Well, go back to the triangle. And I cover over acceleration. And that gives me acceleration equals change in speed divided by change in time. And lastly, suppose I'm interested in the change in time. Then what I do is I cover over time in the bottom, and that tells me that time equals change in speed divided by the acceleration. That's it. So that one mnemonic, in that manner, in that way, will give us four different triangles. And with those four separate triangles for four separate equations, we can rearrange them. So what that actually does, that one mnemonic gives us 12 different equations that we can use to solve physics problems. It's that easy.